So lockdown is kind of over.
Yeah.
And we are back on the boat, and we went, I think, about 13 or something weeks without actually seeing the boat. And as soon as you get here, there's just a...
We're back on the boat and we're on our way to Lough Key Forest Park.
Yes.
So the weather is not great, but we don't care because we're back on the boat.
It's not raining. It did thunderstorm last night and it absolutely lashed out of it. Today though, it is humid. It's clammy, sticky kind of weather, but it's not raining at the moment. Lough Key is it's one of the nicest lakes, I think, of the whole Shannon Navigation. It's the most northerly point of the navigable part of the Boyle River.
It's gorgeous now. I mean,
oh yeah, it is.
Wait, I'd say that now going over, but wait, we're coming back. There's a bit of wind.
Exactly. Well, there's everything here. There's fairy tale castles. There's more than 32 islands. There's, I think, 6 public moorings.
6?
Yeah, one at the lock. 3 at Rockingham. One in Boyle and one down the lake.
Oh, right.
Okay, yeah. So you have six public moorings.
But now in the height of summer, you wouldn't get in here.
Well,
you know, if the sun is shining, anybody with boats, and children especially. Lough Key has an adventure centre now. Well, they have it for a long time, I suppose. It's a fabulous place. There's zip wire, there's...
Borg.
Yeah, I couldn't say that. There's a lovely coffee shop and you can have lunch there. Now, you wouldn't get dinner there, but you get pizza and salad and that kind of stuff, and it's really good. And not expensive.
Yeah. At the time of recording this, none of that is actually open.
No, it's all closed.
Hopefully the next phase or second phase after that.
Only one more phase, the 20th of July, I think everything then is open at that stage.
Okay, yeah.
But it's just so good to be out on the boat, isn't it?
The sense of relaxation when you get down to the boat, like, especially after all the stress of COVID, everybody been stuck at home, and to get down here, back out into the open space, the feeling is kind of hard to put into words, but there really is a wonderful sense of relaxation.
Yeah, yeah.
It really
and even
is.
Though we live in the country, that we wouldn't be, we wouldn't get to us.
We'd have had a bit of freedom either way, because, you know, we could go a few miles from our house, although there was just nothing there. We live in Roscommon, we live in a very rural part of Roscommon, so there's not an awful lot around.
I mean, it was great excitement when you were going to work, so it's late in the season, and when obviously for everybody when we're starting out.
Yeah.
So we're going to try and do as many weekends, if not every weekend, as we can. Obviously, I work one Sunday a month, so that kind of puts it.
Yeah, yeah. That doesn't stop me going boating. It just stops you going boating. That's true. But as soon as I finished work yesterday, I came down to the boat, and Marion was still in work. You were working till late last night. And the first thing I noticed is that when Marion's not on the boat, when you get hungry, the hunger just doesn't go away. It stays there. And it's a strange feeling.
White horses that are around us, and I'm very impressed.
1 minute the sun is out, the next minute it's lashing rain and we're getting squalls and a heck of a lot of wind. But
well, it's lovely now, I have to say, it really is. Yeah. I think this year I've got more confidence as well, haven't I?
Yeah, you have.
27 years.
You should be getting a bit of confidence now. So we're heading out, we're on Lough Key still, and we're heading over here to have a look at somewhere nice. We're going in towards Boyle, but we're not going into the Boyle Canal, we're going to go somewhere else. We'll take it for a spin.
Huckleberry Finland.
It is, yeah, it's Huckleberry Finland. Yeah, that's exactly it. That sums it up well. The old boathouses along here, and many of them are here for probably generations, I would imagine. They're certainly here long time. I'd say they've been home to many a happy fisherman.
I'd say so, but look at those ones there, Harry. They look to be all dilapidated and
nobody. They do, but that's kind of the nice thing about them, that they're not show off. They're not there to impress anybody. They're purely practical.
This is our Huckleberry Finn area now, isn't it? We were up here. Well, it must be 20 years ago with the children.
Right? We were up here before the bypass was built at the end. The bypass was built in 1999. And in fact, on the far side of that bridge, which is now the end of navigation, there's the old wooden jetty.
Yeah, and isn't that, that was the bridge that when the cars, it was a wooden bridge, and when the cars went over, bumpity, bumpity, bump.
Yes.
It would keep you awake half the night.
But it's a tight spot to try and turn around at the end of navigation here. And so I wouldn't fancy it too much on a very windy day.
Oh, I didn't do a bad job when it didn't know, did I?
You did a grand job. But it's just a lovely, beautiful, unspoiled piece of river. And you may have noticed there, there's a sign for sale sign. So we kind of felt that maybe that's going to get sold, maybe it's going to be developed, and this will all be changed. And so we said, better record it now.
Yeah.
So thanks very much for watching, and if you enjoyed the video, guys, don't forget to hit the subscribe button to make sure you get a notification when the next one comes out.
And that's it for now. Cheerio.